In 1957, the founding father of China, Mao Zedong, made a declaration. He said that he is not afraid of nuclear war. Let me quote the exact words. There are 2.7 billion people in the world. It doesn't matter if some get killed. That's what he said. Mao Zedong did not care for human life. His successors have followed in his path. 63 years on, the present Chinese leadership does not care for human life either. A pandemic that began in China has spread to the entire world. More than 1,70,000 people have died, and now China is being held accountable. The world wants China to pay. On Gravitas tonight, we tell you how different stakeholders in at least 5 countries want China to pay for causing deaths, for hiding facts, and for hurting economies. Headline number 1. The American state of Missouri is taking China to court. In the past few weeks, we've reported about private lawsuits from the world over. But this one is different. This is one government suing another. Elected officials in America are taking legal action against China. We have accessed a copy of the lawsuit. It's on your screen right now. Here are the charges. China did not inform the World Health Organization about human-to-human transmission, even when the local medical community had indications. Chinese leaders did little to curb the spread of the virus. They allowed thousands of people to travel in and out of Wuhan. The lawsuit says everything. It talks about how whistleblowers were punished for speaking out. It even talks about faulty medical equipment. But is all of this just to embarrass China? Can a lawsuit like this achieve anything more? Can China be sued in America? Technically, no. Because China enjoys sovereign immunity. But the lawmakers in Missouri are optimistic. China, meanwhile, was quick to dismiss the lawsuit. It says this case is absurd. It lacks factual or legal basis.
This so-called lawsuit is an abuse of litigation which violates basic legal principles. According to the principle of sovereignty equality in international law, the sovereign actions taken by Chinese government at all levels for the epidemic prevention and control are not subject to the jurisdiction of the U.S. courts. Such abuse of litigation is not conducive to the epidemic prevention and control at home in the United States and runs counter to international cooperation. What the United States should do is refute and reject such abuse of litigation.
China may dismiss these lawsuits. These cases might not even stand the scrutiny of court, but that's not stopping people from filing them. Here's another one. An Israeli NGO is planning a class action lawsuit. Shurat Hadin is a Tel Aviv-based civil rights organization. They usually focus on terror victims. This time, they're focusing on a different kind of terror. They plan to sue China for compensation. When the outbreak began, China blocked the flow of information. Transparency could have saved lives. But China attempted a cover-up. And even today, it might be hiding what the world needs to know. Leaders are now demanding facts. What happened in December during the initial days of the outbreak? That's the question that Angela Merkel has asked. The German Chancellor wants a full disclosure from China. Listen to this.
I think that the more transparently China makes clear the story of the emergence of this virus, the better it is for all of us to learn from it. But we have not had this specific discussion.
The German Chancellor is not the only leader to question China. Australia's foreign minister wants a global investigation. Marie Spain wants an investigation into the origin of the virus. An investigation that is done independently and not by the World Health Organization, she says. The Australian minister says that the virus came from China and countries across the world must come together to launch a probe.
I think the key to going forward in the context of these issues is transparency. Transparency from China, most certainly. Transparency from all of the key countries across the world who will be part of any review that takes place. We share some of the concerns that United States have identified in relation to the World Health Organization. That is certainly correct. I think it, though, is about an independent mechanism, and I'm not sure that you can have the health organization, which has been responsible for disseminating much of the international communications material and doing much of the early engagement and investigative work, also as the review mechanism.
She couldn't have been clearer. The Australian Prime Minister has backed the Foreign Minister's call. More transparency. An international investigation depends on global consensus. That may not be easy to achieve. But pressure is mounting on various governments to push in this direction. The United Kingdom, for example, where citizens are now raising this demand. 8 out of 10 people in the UK want China to face a global inquiry. The Henry Jackson Society conducted a poll. They found more than 80% of Britons saying that they would back such an investigation. So 5 countries, the United States, Israel, Germany, Australia, and the United Kingdom, people, governments, organizations, they're all raising the same demand. Make China pay. More power to them, we say.